All right, so Easy 8 into Gotenks is officially in game now, and today we're going to go ahead and take a look at what he's able to do. Of course, this is a multi, like, form transfer racing character, so he starts off as base Gotenks. He does transform the next turn into Super Saiyan Gotenks, and then the turn after transforms into Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks. Pretty good. Full Easy 8. He is max additional for the most part, 20 additional right here, 9 crit and 5 dodge. I could make the build a little better, but we're just going to go with what we have right here. Pretty good stats, basically 15k defense, 21k attack, and then 20k HP. That's quite a bit. So today we're running him on the 200% leader skill for the Super Saiyan Vegeta that came out during Saiyan Day. And we're going to see what he's going to do right here. So again, starting off, he's at 259k defense. This guy's definitely not going to be a slot one character for any means. Unfortunately, I don't really like how these rotations play it out, but that's fine. We do have support from this Super Saiyan Gohan EZA, 30% attack and defense, I believe. So decent little support there. Again, Gotenks right here is going to get a good amount of links, right? We have Saiyan Warrior Race, Saiyan Lineage, Fuse Fighter, and then Fierce Battle here. So how this base Gotenks works is he gets 200% attack and defense, 50% attack on super. Then he has both a high chance to perform an additional super attack and a high chance to dodge enemy attacks. When you dodge an attack, you get an extra 10% dodge chance for that turn. But I believe that only activates once, which is kind of weird that it only activates just once. But based on what I'm understanding, it is just a one-time activation. Now, I can't say that for sure. Maybe I should have put him in someone so we could see. For one turn after his first appearance, he gets 50% defense on super attack. And then, of course, he transforms the next turn. On his super attack effect, he raises attack for the turn and has a 50% defense raise for 3 turns, which will go into his Super Saiyan form here, but we'll see. Again, starting off on an 8 mil attack stats, this could be the high chance, this could be his additional super attack, I'm not sure. If we get one more additional, we'll know for sure that it was either one of the two. It could have been either one of the two, honestly though, but he did get a double super attack right there, so 2 8 mil super attacks right there. Pretty sick. Okay, so we will just continue like this, I guess, right? This transforming Vegeta will just do his thing, and we'll keep S tier Super Vegito here. So we have the King Vegeta next turn. King Vegeta is actually not going to be providing any support. King Vegeta specifically is not really supporting unless you're a pure Saiyan and Vegeta family, which Gotenks is in neither of those teams. I brought him just because I guess he's like a decently good character, but we're not really going to be looking out for King Vegeta being like, oh, you know, he's going to really make Gotenks look very strong. Like, this team doesn't really have too many support characters that I would say would really help out Gotenks besides that Gohan. The issue is that we have that World Tournament's other, like the Super Saiyan Youth Gohan, but you need like a full super class setup for that to work. For that going to really work effectively. I guess he still would give 30% support if I'm not mistaken, right? So at least that'd be a little helpful. All right, so let's see what Super Saiyan Gotenks is able to do here. So I guess we might just put him in slot one in this situation, right? He does still have the 50% chance dodge, but after this guy dodges, he gets 70% dodge for the rest of the turn. Unfortunately, that is separate. I feel like they would... They make that as if it's like one proc, but it is separate. So how it works is he gets a 50% chance to dodge, and after he dodges, he gets a separate 20% extra chance to dodge, right? So it's 50, then 20, not 70% total, unfortunately. But now he gets 250% attack and defense, 50% attack on super attack, then a high chance for another 50% attack on super. Then on top of that, he has a medium chance from a critical hit. And he has a 70% chance to do an additional super attack there. So he's starting off at 549k defense, right? Which is really, really interesting. He has pretty similar of a super attack effects. He does have a 70% chance to stun as pre-EZA, right? But now he does get attack raised for the turn, which he already had. And... defense 50% raise for 4 turns, which used to just be 3 turns. The reason why it's 4 turns is because ideally you actually want to push this guy off rotation, right? How his active skill transformation works is you could use the active skill transformation starting from the 4th turn after transformation, when HP is 70% or more, right? So if we keep him on rotation here, we're going to have turn 1, turn 3, then after turn 5. So we're going to have to wait an extra turn. Oh, which I might have to hop into another event, because it seems like, you know, we're moving by this one pretty fast. To be fair, I gave Gogeta a lot of key. But when it comes to this Gotenk specifically, if you float him off, then it will come back around after. I wonder if there's a way I could, like, miss a lot of key with Super Vegito. I probably... Dang, because... Okay, I could do this. Yeah, I'm trying... Let me manage my key real quick here. And then we'll do this. Hopefully we don't get a lot of supers. That'd be ideal. But because of how that works, with it being the 4th turn after transformation, if you float him off, he'll come back on his 4th turn after transforming, which is the ideal thing you want to do. Now, I actually don't want to finish this phase off here, but it really depends on S tier Vegito and Vegeta himself getting a lot of stacks here and just doing a lot of his shenanigans, right? I say shenanigans, but like, it's more damage. Can you please not? Oh, you're so annoying. Okay. I'm pretty sure we finished him off here, though. Like, very confident. Unless, I mean, Vegito could do a super then through, like, multiple normals. But they have a 70% chance to be a Superman. I don't know. And he also has the crit chance as well. But in... Yeah, okay, now it's over. Man, that sucks. Because I would like to see Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks in a little more action. But again, I guess if anything, I could just hop in and we can get Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks, you know, in an easier situation. So for this spot here, I wonder if I should... just keep Gogeta and then Gogeta Blue, because I have to go Gogeta Blue here, right? That's just a thing we're gonna have to do. But then I do lose out on Golden Warrior, right? Not a big deal, I guess, right? Losing on a Golden Warrior does suck, but then I believe I'll get over in a flash. This is over in a flash, right? Yeah, I will get over in a flash when I go into Super Saiyan 3, so probably will prefer that. Should I put Gotenks in the front? I feel like it's a bad idea. Because the thing about Gotenks is he doesn't get any defense when attacking. He only has a dodge chance. And then I don't think that 4-turn 50% defense raise is going to make this guy like get so much defense that he can start taking supers. So probably we'll just have to push you and someone for now. Which is okay, right? It's not the worst thing in the world. Would have preferred not to have to do that, but that's fine. And then I don't really want to transform with you. So, you should be okay. Maybe I should have put Gotenks off, but that's fine. As long as you dodge this, we're good. Okay, cool. That's the most important part. All right, we're good. We're looking good here. So we'll see another turn of Gotenks here doing his thing again. Then we'll transform to Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks. We'll have the 30% supports, and hopefully we'll get a pretty good looking rotation. I just don't want to do too much damage, but luckily this Golden Frieza is pretty tanky for the most part. We'll see what happens. I'm a little scared because we're gonna do a lot of damage next turn. Do I just like, what if I just finish Frieza off and then we get to the S tier phase at the end? I guess we could do that, right? If I finish Frieza off next turn and then it gets to the S tier phase, because I'm trying to plan things out so where we can see Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks attack a lot. Worst case scenario, I'll just hop into that like that one Goku Black and Zamasu event where, like, Zamasu has, like, an infinite amount of HP, and then we can see Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks really go to town there. But I also do want to make sure I show Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks in, like, an actual event. Where I feel like, you know, this kind of event length is something we could see in actual, like, new anniversary content, right? But yeah, again, we got the 70% super attack chance right there. You didn't even dodge Gotenks. Good job. So I think I'll just skip ahead at this point, and then we'll go ahead and see what Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks is looking like from here. Alright, so I did exactly that, but I don't know, I feel like we're gonna do a lot of damage here. I'm not sure if we're gonna see, if we could see Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks, like, go crazy, then I actually will be satisfied. But, so Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks, right? Well, again, we could use transform with him from the fourth turn onward after his Super Saiyan transformation, if your HP is above 70%, which we do see here. Luckily, Blue Gogeta himself is a very big contributor to seeing that 70% HP restriction be met. But the last thing about this Super Saiyan Gotenks is he does have a high chance of recovering 30% HP, right, from the fourth turn onward. So I assume it doesn't say fourth turn from first appearance. It just says fourth turn. I haven't seen it because this is my first time using this guy. But I think on how that wording is, that is basically from when he's transforming. Because, well, he could transform in turn three. So, like, turn four in the start of battle, right? Rather than turn four from his first appearance. But I guess I can't see for sure. Again, it says fourth turn onwards rather than fourth and first appearance. Think of, like, God Topo's active skill. That says from the sixth turn. Not sixth turn from his first appearance, right? So, okay, we'll transform here. Let's play this animation. It's been a while since I've seen this one, and I'm very excited to, actually. Alright, so Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks starting off at 657k defense, or 675k defense. I can't read apparently. Keep in mind, the 50% stacks from last turn do carry over to this rotation. So we got two super attacks. He has two 50% super attack effect stacks. His super attack effect now is that he has a 4 turn 50% attack and defense raise, immense damage, and a 70% chance to stun. So the real big thing that changes is that 1 turn attack raise is now 4 turns, which is pretty nice. He gets key 3 and 300% attack and defense, 100% attack on super, and a high chance to crits. He always does a guaranteed additional super attack. He has a 70% chance to dodge, and after he dodges, he gets 20% extra chance to dodge. Then he guarantee crits for one turn after first appearance, which is this very first turn here. So he's actually, I feel like, more simple compared to a lot of these other, like, recent wall, like, paragraph characters. Like, Ageo Bardock, I feel like, as a character, is like, he has so much in his, like, written down. Not saying that he's, like, a crazy character, but I feel like, you know, Ageo Bardock as a character, it's like, oh, he has so much written down in there, with, like, all this different damage reduction, all these other chances to crit or dodge, and it's like, this guy is more, like, I guess, straightforward with what he's doing, which, you know, he just has a flat-out 70% chance to dodge. He just flat-out has the guaranteed crit for the turn. You guys get what I mean? Just a guaranteed additional super, right? This guy's not playing around. He's a straight up good. So we'll see what he's going to look like in terms of his offensive numbers here. We're getting the 30% support from this Super Saiyan High School Kid Gohan. High School Kid Gohan, hello. High School Gohan, let's see. So a 15 mil attack stat straight up, and he's doing a guaranteed double super attack. That's good. Okay, and then here's another one right there, 16 mil. And then we could get the Hidden Potential System super attack, which I'm not sure if we've seen yet, but I hope we see it right now. We got the normal right there, but I mean, okay, so that could have been three, like, different super attacks of 15 to 16 to 17 mil with guaranteed crit. Then he would also be with a 70% chance to dodge, right? And his defense is probably over a million at this point. Like, for sure. So, I want to say for sure, but his defense is pretty likely close to being near a million, which is really, really nice, right? But let me take a look. Actually, I know Halvard has calculations for this. We can see. What is the Halvard calculations looking like here for this guy? What is it looking like? Here is the Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks here. So, with three super attack effect stacks, he's over a million defense with two additional supers. So, yeah, he's probably, yeah, I would say he's probably closer to 900k defense than 1 million. But again, he is a character with 70% chance to dodge, which is really, really huge. I feel pretty satisfied with what I saw, actually. I don't think I really have to do any more No. I guess we don't have to move to the Zamasu bat. I think Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks itself looks amazing. To be honest, not really, like, impressed by base and Super Saiyan Gotenks, but they're still good. It's more like, you know, they're pretty, like, I wouldn't say even necessarily, like, they're crazy or good, even. Like, they seem decent. The base form Gotenks for a turn one performance, I'll take it. For Super Saiyan Gotenks, for a character that you're probably just going to be floating off instantly, is good. And the great thing about Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks is, before ZZA, he had like that 4-turn passive, where he has the Kree 3 and great chance of launching an additional super attack for 4 turns, right? But now, post ZZA, the only thing that's turn restricted when he goes Super Saiyan 3 is the guaranteed crit for the turn. And then after that, he still has a high chance to crit, so you can get this guy out as soon as possible, and he's going to be able to cook. So let me know what you guys think about Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks. In Gotenks looks pretty good, and I'll catch you guys next time.